When is 3/4 actually 2/3? Hi, biology friends. It's Sarah, your other biology professor, and let's talk about lethal alleles. Some genes encode a function that is critical to the survival of an organism. A mutated version of one of these genes that disrupts that necessary function, leading to the death of the organism, is a lethal allele. The timing of lethality depends on when that product is needed. Lethality could occur early in development, like before birth in mammals, after birth, or not until adulthood. Diploid organisms, like you and me, inherit 2 copies of each chromosome. That's 2 alleles for each gene. Is a single lethal allele enough to see lethality, or do you need to have 2? Well, it depends. If the allele is not lethal in the heterozygote, but only in the homozygous genotype, then it is a recessive lethal allele. 2 are required for lethality. 1 normal copy of the allele is enough to compensate to keep the organism alive. Now, the classic example of a recessive lethal allele comes from studies of mouse coat color with the agouti gene, which encodes a product that is involved in cell signaling, cellular communication. Basically, it determines which pigments are deposited in the hairs. Now, there are many alleles for this gene, but 2 important ones here are agouti, which leads to an almost alternating black and yellow pigment deposition in the hairs, and yellow, which is yellow. Through a variety of crosses, it was determined that yellow is dominant to agouti. You only need 1 yellow allele to get the yellow phenotype. If you take 2 yellow mice and breed them together, the offspring have a phenotypic ratio of 2 yellow to 1 agouti. And now, if you've spent some time working with crosses, that's not a Mendelian ratio that you'd expect to see, right? So what's going on here? Well, the agouti homozygotes are agouti, the heterozygotes are yellow, and the yellow homozygotes are dead. So all the yellow mice are actually heterozygotes, and in a cross between 2 heterozygotes, you'd expect a 3-to-1 ratio of yellow to agouti, 3/4 yellow, 1/4 agouti. But instead, a 2-to-1 ratio is observed, 2/3 yellow to 1/3 agouti. Why? Well, the lethality occurs early in development. So the 1/4 of mice that you would expect to see as homozygous yellow aren't observed. The yellow allele encodes a dominant trait, as we saw with the heterozygotes being yellow. But because 2 copies of the yellow allele are required for lethality, yellow is a recessive lethal allele. Stay with me. Recessive lethal alleles can encode dominant or recessive traits, but they only lead to death when 2 copies are found in an individual. So here, yellow was dominant to agouti for the coat color phenotype, but recessive for lethality. So this gene impacts both a coat color phenotype as well as survivability. This is an example of pleiotropy, a single gene controlling multiple unrelated characteristics. So then what would a dominant lethal allele look like? And how many copies of that allele would be required for lethality? Just 1. With a dominant lethal allele, the lethality would be seen in both the homozygous dominant and the heterozygous genotypes. Dominant lethal alleles are more rare because all individuals with a copy of that allele are susceptible to the lethality. And if lethality occurs before reproductive age, that allele isn't being passed on to the next generation. Dominant lethal alleles are only passed on if the lethality is incompletely penetrant, meaning some individuals with the lethal alleles don't express the lethal phenotype due to environmental factors or other aspects of their genetic background, or if the lethality is late onset, meaning it doesn't occur until after the individual will have been at reproductive age. Both of these apply to Huntington's disease in humans, a progressive neurodegenerative disorder where symptoms and lethality don't typically arise until an individual is in their 40s or later, after which point they may have already had children and passed that Huntington's allele onto their offspring. And because Huntington's is a dominant lethal, a single copy of that disease allele can cause the disease symptoms and lethality. Let's review. An allele is a recessive lethal allele if two copies of that allele are necessary to see the lethality. And it's a less common dominant lethal allele if only one copy is necessary. Lethal alleles can lead to some unexpected ratios in crosses. And remember that lethal alleles can impact other characteristics besides just lethality. And those other phenotypes can have separate dominant and recessive dynamics, like what we saw with the yellow allele in mouse coat color. The yellow allele was a recessive lethal allele, but dominant for coat color phenotype. For more biology content to pass those exams, or if you're just curious, be sure to subscribe. And if you learned something about lethal alleles, give me a thumbs up. If you're looking for tutoring resources, be sure to check out my website. And otherwise, I will see you next time.